Interestingly enough, we also have this object that's called the marketing events object, which is the one that gets thrown in the way that we use it. And kind of also, interestingly enough, an event, a marketing event can have events in the data context, right? So someone can attend an event that is an event in the data context. I hope somebody out there is following that. But then the event itself, and if you, let's take a real example, let's take inbound. So HubSpot has our annual conference that we call inbound. Details about inbound actually might evolve as the event gets planned, right? So the specific time, the specific speakers, who's registered versus who has confirmed, things like that, that's going to evolve as the event comes closer, as the event passes. That's a good way to think about why is this an object and not necessarily an event. Attending inbound, now they've done an event. So it's a little bit tricky when you think about it, but using it in the context of like a real use case, like a conference that you are attending, helps to kind of sort through what the word means in a given context. I hope that was semi-digestible.
To put it in the context of this webinar is a marketing event, but you attending this webinar could be a custom event if we had an integration set up to put it on our contact timelines.
Yeah. It also could be an event that is within the marketing events object. The marketing events team has a fantastic import beta that's going right now. If you're looking for infrastructure around managing attendance and who's canceled, who has confirmed, the marketing events object, that import is creating events that are specifically designed for that. You can also use custom events for it because custom events is kind of like generic activity import. So it kind of depends on how much supporting functionality you're looking for.